Welcome to Hypnosis Today, the nation's first web TV talk show that explores the fascinating world of hypnotherapy. Hello, my name is Lisa Machenberg, and I'll be your host covering a wide variety of subjects to help you understand the power of the subconscious mind and how hypnosis is being used today to help people achieve success, happiness, and prosperity. It is my pleasure to introduce you to Jane George. Let me make sure I get this right. And she is the founder and owner of Body Mind Realign, and she has an office in Pacific Palisades. And Jane, we're going to start off with my favorite topic in the whole world, which is the integration of intuition with heart science. Can you tell me a little bit about your background?
Sure. My father was an engineer in the nuclear industry, and my mother was a very girly girl. And so I grew up with a lot of both of those aspects, things from my father, things from my mother. So I ended up doing my undergraduate and my master's degrees in biology at UCLA. So I'm a science girl. But I also have a lot of intuitive and more heart-driven realities in terms of my own work and perspectives with working with bodies. And so I decided to become a chiropractic doctor rather than going into the medical world, where I could allow myself to fuse those two concepts in working with patients.
And speaking of fusing two things, you did that for a while, and then I believe it was in 2009 you decided that you wanted to add hypnotherapy to your chiropractic practice.
That's right. So there's only so far you can go working with the body.
Yes.
You know, we all tend to store things in the body, and emotionally, stress, and this is real. This isn't voodoo. This is real chemical cascades that happen within the physiology of the body that get stored and trapped inside muscles as real chemical reactions. And because it was an emotional event or a stressful event that put it there, we can go and work to move those obstacles physically. But if we don't deal with the emotional aspect of it, it's going to still stick around, probably flare up again, become a chronic issue.
Yes.
And so hypnotherapy made so much sense in terms of finding ways to address those kinds of issues, finding faster ways to heal the body physically. And even for people who are doing traditional talk therapy, even in conjunction with that, to move things along at a faster rate and see deeper healing.
Sure. Do you integrate hypnotherapy with all of your chiropractic clients? Or do you integrate chiropractic with all your hypnotherapy clients?
I do both. I mean, I have patients that are specifically chiropractic patients. They come in for physical work. That's what they want to do. And then I have patients that are solely hypnotherapy patients, and that's what they want to do with me. Most of my patients get a blend. That's the beauty of this kind of work. I do one particular treatment. Shall I share it?
I'd love to hear about it.
I do one particular treatment. I see when people come in with low back pain, and it's been a recurring thing in their lives, especially for women, I find that there's oftentimes an emotional component to that.
Yes.
And so we'll do the traditional physical therapy, which is using something called E-stim. Medical doctors use it, physical therapists use it, we use it, chiropractors use it. And we'll do that to work to reset the muscles in the low back. It's great for discs, it's great for inflammation, it's just an awesome modality.
But you add one additional thing.
And so while they're going through that protocol, it gives me 15 minutes to actually do hypnotherapy with a patient. And for somebody who's got emotional blockages going on in that part of their body as well, we can use that current. It's right in there. That electric current is already present in the body. We can start to use it in a hypnotic state to move that current and the sensation of that current through the body. And we move it through, I call them highways. Let's create energetic highways, pulling that energy through the body. And then after we go through that process of creating this whole system of highways in the body, then we start to dump that energy into cells. And we turn those cells on. We use something that's very tangible. It's right there. And we use through the hypnotic state and the power of the mind. And you know how powerful the subconscious mind is. Because we can make somebody salivate just thinking about lemons, right?
Absolutely.
So if we can use that same idea, which we do in hypnotherapy and our work every day, to use something physical and move it through the body and create an effect in the body through the power of the mind, recharge up every cell in your body. Those patients get off the table, and yeah, their back feels better, and you would expect that. It's a traditional protocol, But in addition to that, they feel alive and vibrant and ecstatic because their cells are charged up as well.
Yes. Now, here at HMI, you learned another protocol, but you adapted it in a way that I never even thought of. You learned about the mental bank. For the people who are not familiar with it, can you give us a tiny little overview of what the mental bank is and then how you adapted it?
Well, sure. I mean, the mental bank was adopted by our, you know, our guru.
Which is Dr. John Kappas.
Dr. John Kappas. And it was developed for people, if you would be willing to invest 3 minutes of your day into your life, would you be willing to do that to change your relationship with money and be living in a state of abundance? And as the sun said, probably you wouldn't, even though everybody raises their hands.
Uh-huh.
But the truth is, it's a great protocol. And if you are willing to commit it, I would say go for it. I see so many people use it in so many powerful and positive ways in their life. I had a patient who is an analyst. She's a day trader. Mm-hmm. That's how she thinks. She thinks about money. She loved the idea of the mental bank. So we decided that it would be a great opportunity for her in terms of weight loss. She wanted to lose weight.
So I'm going to just here for 1 minute and say that with the mental bank, you actually make mental bank entries and give yourself deposits.
Well, what you do is you look at caloric burn. So on any given day, if you're trying to lose weight, you know that to burn a pound of fat takes 3,500 calories. You got to get less of it. Either burn it off or eat less.
Yes.
So you give yourself the goal of what your weight's going to be, and you use the mental bank process calorically instead of as dollars.
I love it.
So in other words, if you burn, and if you at the end of the day, your goal is 1,350 calories, and that's where you sit, then that's where you sit, and the reward is going to be the weight loss.
Yes.
If you go 500 calories over and you don't burn those, you just took money out of your bank, right? Because you've overspent, you're overdrawn. So it's going to take longer. So it's a great premise for using the mental bank. You still use the ledgers just exactly like you would if you were doing it for financial resources. It's really simple to calculate because you set a date. What is your caloric change have to be? And how are you going to set about doing it?
So I would ask you a couple of questions about that because I personally use the mental bank.
And good for
you.
Me
too. Thank you. I use it for prosperity. And what I do is I put those events that I know I need to do to create prosperity, like handing out my business cards, doing my mailing to my mailing list, scheduling lectures to large groups where I know there are people who would be receptive to hypnotherapy. And I pay myself for each of those events or each of those goals that I accomplish. Each time I schedule a lecture, I pay myself.
That's right.
How would it work with calories? What are some of those events that you'd pay yourself for?
Okay, well, one of the big ones is I have all of my patients who are doing weight loss, and even patients who aren't, who just want to become more active, do the 10,000 steps a day. 10,000 steps a day is what we all should be getting. And you get these little walking counters that you wear, and it tells you how much you're doing. Now let's say that in addition to that 10,000, you did 5,000 extra. Well, that actually means you can eat that piece of fudge at the end of the day because you've burned enough calories to do it. So that's where you get, if you decide that you're going to do a day of fasting, perhaps juice fasting, and so your caloric intake is going to be less, then you're going to have the advantage of that. Now the obvious advantage is the logical consequence, which is just the weight loss. That's our goal here. So if you are meeting your demands from a caloric exchange, you're going to lose the weight. That's the true benefit. If you want to have a benefit of, well, I'm going to a wedding and I want a piece of wedding cake, then you can have that too. But we don't want food to become a reward. We want the reward to be being healthy, having lost the weight, feeling vibrant and good in life.
Are you using the hypnosis principles of writing in your mental bank or your beautiful light and healthy body bank ledger, do you write right before bed?
Yes, absolutely. We do this, we do all the stuff that's part of the mental bank. We do set your day. That's really important.
Yes.
You have to do that just like you do with the mental bank. The protocols are identical. The only difference is the exchange rate is calories, not money.
I love it. You know, this is fascinating. And I know that so many people are going to want to learn how to integrate body work or chiropractic work with hypnotherapy or take advantage of the work that you do. I'm sure everybody is going to want to learn about how to do the weight, light and healthy body mental bank method. if people would like to contact you, what's the best place for people to email you?
The best way to email me is through askdrjane@gmail.com. And that's all the words are spelled out, askdrjane, J-A-N-E, at gmail.com.
And you'd be happy to teach people some of your methods?
I would love it. I mean, I think there's so many people out there that we don't need to compete.
Yes.
You know, we need to be working together and supporting one another, because the ultimate goal is to live in a healthier, happier, more highly functional society. And there's so many people out there that I believe will benefit from the kind of work that we do, that anybody that I can share this information with. You were very generous with me when I came to you about birthing work.
Yes.
And I absolutely want to commend that energy, because you didn't say, oh, you have to pay this and you have to go.
Oh, no, as a matter of fact.
You just opened your heart and said, here, Jane, use this.
Yes.
Let me know how it goes.
Jane,
you know?
I was very, very happy that Jane was interested in my Joyous Labor and Childbirth program with hypnosis, and it was my pleasure to share it with you.
Thank you.
But studio audience, those at home, we are out of time for today. So what we are going to do is we are going to take a break, and I am going to return with my next guest, who is going to be talking about how to balance family life with hypnotherapy practice, another one of my favorite topics. But before we go, I want to thank Jane George of Body Mind Realign. Her practice is in Pacific Palisades, California. You can reach her at askdrjane@gmail.com. And I want to thank you so much for being a guest
thank
on
you.
My show
thank
and
you
sharing
so
this
much.
Wonderful information.
Thank you.
Thank you.